and gentlemen, so my name is Dr. Mena Bright, like you already know. Today you are welcome to this channel, my DMSI channel. And today on this video, I'll be talking to you something that a lot of people really don't like talking about, all right? You know, even as adults, people don't want to talk about sex and sexual interactions or communications that involve sexual intercourse and stuff like that. And yet, it's a big problem. So, the title of this video is What Impotence Does to You. Let me not waste much of your time. We already know what impotence is. But just for as a matter of introduction, if you're a man and you're watching this video, impotence just means inability of you to sustain, to have an erection, a penile erection, your penis getting erected and hard enough for you to be able to penetrate your woman's vagina. And if you're a woman and you're watching this video, let me tell you that impotence will mean to you inability of your man to get erections, for your man's penis to be hard enough to be able to penetrate your vagina. So, coming from that basic definition, we can make proper reference to what the topic is. What impotence does to you? What does impotence do to you as a man, especially as a man, all right? So, I will just give you paint you a scenario. Let's assume, for example, that you are there's this beautiful lady that you'll be trying to like want to get down with you for a long time. You've been making advances at her. You've done everything possible. She's really be forthcoming though, but you've not just had the time to get to meet, and you've made all manner of arrangements. Say for example that you've met her on a social media platform, say Twitter, for example. You've had several exchanges of messages in your inboxes and have even gone ahead to exchange phone numbers. So you now do WhatsApp and you'll be talking and you'll be looking forward to when you probably meet each other, okay? And then eventually you find the time and she visited on that day. You were prepared for her visit. You made every arrangement as it concerns making sure that everything goes on just well, all right? Your environment is cozy. You guys watch movies, probably ate something, took drinks. And thereafter, she goes to the bathroom, takes her bath, all right? And then she returns from the bathroom, all right, dressed in a beautiful nightgown. Do you understand that? And stop for a moment and imagine that a beautiful girl returns from the bathroom dressed in a beautiful nightgown, all right, transparent nightgown. What does that tell you, okay? You assume, you conclude that, oh, great, your work at getting her to sleep with you is almost half done. She looks like she's ready. She also wants it. And obviously, she wants it. Okay, so then you people get to stay under the duvet, and then you kudo, you touch each other and do everything possible. And then you get to the point, really, where she begins to actually ask for it. She asks, she wants you to come into her. And then suddenly, not suddenly, you have observed that for all this time that you've been doing, everything that you've been doing, nothing seems to have happened. Your penis has gone like this. You know what I mean? It's done this. All right? So you try everything possible. You've tried to further do your foreplay with her, and it just stays like this. For those who have been in that situation, I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. And from this point onward, it's not usually funny. And I mean it. If you're laughing at the way the penis usually can go limp, like it just completed a round, even when it's done nothing yet, all right, in those who are affected by impotence, it's not really a laughing matter. I know because I've seen people who have been in that kind of situation, and then it affects everything thereafter. Okay, so I'm talking about what it does to you. You see, just as the penis goes like this, if you are unable to get it soft at that moment, your whole life, almost your whole life, goes like this. All right. So to begin with, it drains your energy, just as the energy from the power from the penis is drained. This kind of scenario usually will drain your energy. It sucks life out of you. It sucks power out of you, and that you could feel it that something had left you. All right, it reduces your self-esteem to the barest minimum. It's something, and thereafter, after reducing yourself, especially if the partner that this thing has happened with is not a very nice person, if it's or probably is not a very friendly person, if it's someone who probably will even go ahead mocking you and making you and feeling angry that you really are not making it look like it's your fault, really, it's even worse. Okay, so it's that's what it does to your self-esteem. That will further make your self-esteem to go south. And when your self-esteem goes south and you keep dwelling on it, because you dwell on it, this is something you have looked forward to, you've prepared for. You thought you did everything, and just when you needed it the most, and then it does this, okay? You now, for that, it could cause you depression, and then when depression sets in, every other thing is actually affected, just like depression usually affects every other thing, okay? And sometimes the thought of it alone makes you want to not continue, all right? I've had series of situations like this, and it affects them until a solution actually comes. It will not, until they are, even when they are able to now get an erection with the next person, with another spouse or with another partner, that's, they are unable to get detached from that particular scenario. Like I said, if the partner is someone who is not very good, that means she probably didn't even make any attempt to try to help you. She just also felt angry. She ditched you because it's going to continue. It's psychologically, it affects you. It keeps it there. And if she's somebody you actually liked before, it's even worse because it feels like you are you of course it means you're not man enough, and even when you become man enough with other ladies, you understand, it's the feeling that person sees you as not man enough will continue to haunt you. All right, so if you are watching this video, the purpose for this video is so you can understand the extent or the possible damage that impotence or inability to get an erection and be able to consummate a sexual relationship can cause to you. And if you understand how much it can cause to you, you will know that there is need for you to protect your sexual health as a man, and even as a woman, there's need for you to help your man protect your sexual health. This video is a precursor to another video I plan to make, where I'll be talking about how to prevent erectile dysfunction, or what I've referred to as impotence, what usually we call impotence. It is true that most men, 2 out of 3 men, would have done something, either a medication or some kind of art, to see that they keep erection, the erection is good, and they are able to. Because for a man, really, what's the joy in a man is to see that the partner is satisfied. All right, people want to leave an impression of, oh man, he did this to me, or I did this to her. And once that is not possible, it's usually a problem. So I like that you watch this video with someone that you like. If you're a female, watch this video with your partner, or recommend this video to somebody who you think may need it, so that everybody will need it. This video should actually be seen so that by those who even haven't had this kind of experience, because the purpose is to see that you prevent that this kind of experience ever happens. And there are a few things that you should be able to do that to keep up your erection for almost as long as you live. I used to joke with my friends that I want to be having an erection even I'm 100 years old. I know a lot of you also agreed that you will want to be having an erection even at, somebody said that he wants to die an old person having an erection. All right, so thank you for watching my video, and I hope you subscribe to my YouTube channel. We'll be bringing you another episode that will be talking about ways to prevent your impotence, or we call it ways to protect your sexual health. All right, thank you.